In this series, we're going to take your piece from this to this. All using skills, tips, and tricks brought to you right here. There's no previous learning needed, no fancy plugins or synthesizers, and no musical understanding. The only things you'll need will be your eyes, your ears, a door, and a sample instrument. So come on, let's get started. Hi, Adam with Audio Imperia here, and welcome back to the second part of our tutorial series, The Journey to Becoming a Composer. In episode 1, we covered the very basics of MIDI composition, looking at what MIDI is and how you can use a DAW and a sample playback engine along with a sample library like our all-in-one orchestral library Nucleus to begin composing music using your computer. We created a MIDI track inside of our DAW, connected it to Kontakt, the sample playback engine Nucleus uses, and then loaded up a virtual instrument so that we could use Nucleus to begin producing music. Now, if none of this is making any sense, don't worry, we provided a link to episode 1 in the description box down below, so go check that out and then join us for this episode. In this episode, we're going to be looking at how we can use MIDI to begin accessing some of the key features inside Nucleus, features that will allow us to begin shaping our music and crafting more realism and expressiveness into our compositions. Let's start by exploring a key feature common to many sample libraries, including Nucleus, articulations. When musicians play instruments, they don't just play them in one way. They can play them in long, sustained notes, for example, or in short, sharp notes. And most instruments have playable techniques specific to them. For example, violins can be bowed using a bow, or they can be plucked with the finger in a technique called pizzicato, from the Italian meaning pinched. We record instruments being played not just at a variety of pitches and volumes, but also using a variety of techniques or articulations. Having access to these different methods of playing allows you to enhance the realism of your music, and opens up a range of possibilities when composing too. Here I've loaded up the two flutes patch inside Nucleus. There's a whole bunch of controls here, many of which we'll cover in the later episodes, but you'll see right in the middle of everything is a list of different articulations. The sustained articulation gives us a beautiful long held note, great for creating melodies or chords where we want these kinds of held notes. Below, we have a staccatissimo articulation. Staccatissimo is another common musical Italian phrase that basically means very detached, or, in other words, very short. You can hear this is very different to the sustained articulation, creating a much shorter, sharper sound with a lot of attack. We also have two types of trill, a half note trill and a whole note trill. A trill is basically a technique whereby a musician very rapidly alternates between two different notes. In the half note trill, we have the musician alternating between a note and another note a half step above. You can hear the resulting sound is quite tense. You might have heard this technique before in a lot of orchestral music. The whole note trill is exactly the same, but the player alternates between a note and a second note a whole step up. The resulting sound is similar, but generally sounds less tense and a little more hopeful or happy. You can see how all these different articulations will come in handy when composing music, and you can also see how you might want to change between different articulations during a piece of music too, to create the sense that a real musician is using different techniques at different points. So how do we go about switching between these different articulations? One way is to load each articulation into a different MIDI track. Let me show you what I mean. Here I've created two MIDI tracks. One is called Two Flutes Sustained, and the other, Two Flutes Staccatissimo. Our Two Flutes Sustained MIDI track is connected to an instance of Kontakt with our Two Flutes patch loaded in. You can see I've selected the sustained articulation, and I've switched off all the other articulations by shift-clicking the articulation that I want to use. We don't need these, and disabling them helps save memory and improve performance when composing. On our two flute staccatissimo MIDI track, I've done the exact same thing, but this time I've selected the staccatissimo articulation and disabled the others. So now I have two tracks, one for sustained notes and one for staccatissimo notes. I can write the notes I want to sound sustained into my sustained MIDI track and the notes I want played staccatissimo into my staccatissimo MIDI track, like in this example. I could even use both tracks at the same time to create a more accented sustained note, like in this example. Here, I'm copying the same MIDI part onto both the sustained and staccatissimo tracks. You can hear that combining both creates a slightly different, but still very usable sound compared to using one or the other separately. But what if you don't want to load an individual track for every articulation? What if you want to keep your flute, for example, on just one MIDI track, but still have access to every different articulation? This is completely possible, and to do it, we use a technique called keyswitching. Let's go back to our two flutes patch inside of Kontakt. You can see at the bottom of Kontakt, we have a piano keyboard roll displayed. In addition to the usual black and white keys you'd find on a piano, we have two other different colored keys, blue keys and red keys. In Nucleus, blue keys show playable keys, in other words, keys where the instrument produces a sound. Let me demonstrate. Red keys, however, do something different. If I play a red key, you can see that instead of producing a musical note, it switches the articulation in the articulation panel. These keys instruct the sample playback engine to switch between articulations, hence key switching. We can see which key switch is used for which articulation in the articulations panel above. C1, for example, switches to our sustained articulation. C#1, the next note, switches to our staccatissimo articulation. We can use this feature to go back to our MIDI editor and actually switch between articulations in real time. Let me show you how. Here I have some chords being played on our two flutes patch, but at this point, I want the chords to switch from long sustained notes to short staccatissimo notes. I can do this by using a key switch. It's as simple as placing a short note at the appropriate pitch. As mentioned, the sustained notes are triggered via the C1 key, so I'll put a short note there right at the beginning. At this point, I want the flutes to play staccatissimo. We can see the staccatissimo is triggered using the C#1 key switch, so I'll place a note in there just as I want my flutes to change articulation. When we listen back, we can hear the flutes change articulation at the appropriate point. And we've done this all inside one MIDI track, keeping our workflow nice and streamlined while still offering us lots of options when crafting our MIDI performances. In summary, articulations are different types of musical techniques, and most realistic music performances will use more than one articulation throughout the piece. Experiment to find out which system works best for you. Workflow is a highly personal part of our composition process, and there's no right or wrong way to do things. It's all about your preferences. Nevertheless, this episode has hopefully explained what articulations are, what key switches are, and given you an idea of how you can use them in your own work. In the next episode, we're really going to begin pushing our MIDI programming by exploring two key concepts, dynamics and expression. These two features will take your music to the next level and are an essential component in any good MIDI composition. Thanks for watching, and we hope you'll join us in the next episode.